Одними из самых интересных образований, которые мне приходилось видеть во время многочисленных экспедиций в разные страны Средиземноморского региона, это древние каменные дороги и колеи. То есть я их...
One of the most interesting formations that I saw during the numerous expeditions to different countries of the Mediterranean region are ancient stone roads and ruts. I saw them in Spain in the provinces of Valencia, Castilla-Mancha, Murcia, Granada, Sorry, in central Italy in the zone of development of Etruscan settlements, including Cerveteri, Castel d'Elso, Sarana, Savana, Pitiliana and other places. Stone ruts are particularly widespread in central Anatolia and Cappadocia in Turkey. They also exist in many other countries.
В центральной Анатолии, в Каппадокии, в Турции, ну и различные другие страны. Вот. То, что мне приходилось видеть, то, что приходилось изучать, исследовать, ходить и вдоль и поперек.
What I had seen and studied, what I had gone along with and across, as well as numerous photos I got from familiar researchers. First of all, from Andrei Kuznetsov, my partner in the first expedition to Turkey, from Uwe Schreider from Germany, and Jan-Peter de Jong from Belgium. Testified to the wide spreading of stone roads and ruts in Turkey, Malta, Montenegro, France, Germany, Switzerland, Austria, Portugal, Azerbaijan, Georgia, Armenia and Kazakhstan. The photos available in the internet show that similar stone ruts are widely represented in North America, United States, Mexico. Recently, I have also received the photos of stone ruts from Brazil and India. That is, they are well developed. My studies in expeditions show that we deal with not individual ruts, but with widespread clusters and groups of ruts.
Такие колеи есть и в Грузии, и даже в Армении, и при Каспийских областях Казахстана. Также, судя по фотографиям, которые циркулируют в интернете, эти колеи есть в разных районах Северной Америки, Соединенные Штаты Америки, Мексика. Вот. И, то есть, как мы видим, их распространение достаточно широкое. То есть, то, что...
When I try to read in the literature, primarily archaeological, about these stone ruts and the history of their research, then, to my surprise, I discovered that almost nothing was said about them. For example, a huge field of ruts in Cappadocia, which has a size of 100 to 150 kilometers, is not mentioned anywhere. If it were not for my partner on the first expedition, Andrei Kuznetsov, who found them on the Google map and traveled there, then nothing would have been known about them at all.
100 на 150 километров, вообще ничего не говорилось и нигде не говорится. И если бы не мой партнер Андрей Кузнецов, наверное, они так бы оставались бы неизвестны, который их обнаружил на карте Google и исследовал туда, съездил с экспедицией, привез уникальные фотографии. Второе поле колей во Фригийской долине...
We found the second field of stone ruts between the Turkish cities of Eskihir and Afyon by chance, when we pursued completely different goals and studied underground and rock towns of Turkey. Once we drove along a normal dirt road, as we moved, the wheels began to fall deeper and deeper, and it was dangerous to go. We went out and saw that the car was going along the stone ruts. From that moment, we started to study them.
Идет по окаменевшей колее, и тогда началось вот наше изучение. Вот. Ну, на следующей колее Кастелар де Мека, в первую очередь, система в Испании, в Бакариенте колее.
The next stone ruts primarily in Castellar de Meca, Bucara and Jumilla, Termes in Spain I visited already targeted. As well as ruts in Italy, these are the ruts in Cerveteri, Castel d'Asso and so-called Roman roads in Pitiliana, Sarana, Savana. I conducted a comprehensive study of these ruts. I measured their width, the distance between the tracks and conducted many other measurements. I also looked at the rocks in which they are located, studied geological maps and determined the age of the rocks according to them. It was especially easy to do for Spain because geological maps of Spain are publicly available. They can be downloaded from the geological funds of Spain for free. Therefore, it is not difficult to study the geology of different areas by them. With Italy and Turkey, everything is a bit more complicated, but I also managed to find the necessary geological maps and studied them. When I went to some ruts, I more or less knew the age of the rocks in which they are located.
Образование каменных дорог и каменных колей, то первое, что, наверное, нужно сказать, все они приурочены к неогеновой поверхности выравнивания. Неогеновая поверхность.
To sum up the results of my long study of stone roads and rats, the first thing to say is that they are all confined to the Neogene planation plain or to the Neogene land. It is quite well dated. In Turkey, for example, its age is defined in the range between 15 and 11 million years ago, according to some data up to 7 million years ago. Definitions of the absolute age of rocks narrows its age range to 14-12 million years ago.
Ну, а вообще, эта поверхность уравнива образовалась после известного события, как столкновение Африки, Аравии с окраиной Евразии и подъемом горной системы, подъемом Альп, Пиренеев.
This planation plain was formed after a famous event, the collision of Africa and Arabia with the edge of Eurasia, and the subsequent ascent of the Alps, the Pyrenees, the Apennines, the Carpathians, the Caucasus, the Crimean Mountains, and others. The collision began at the turn of the early and middle Miocene about 15.9 million years ago. As a result, 15 and more millions of years ago, this area began to heave up and the archipelag of islands formed on the place where the Tethys Ocean existed up to 15 million years ago. Some of the islands were fairly large, almost small continents, such as Iberia, Italy, Greece, Turkey.
Iberia, Italia. Вот, Греция, Турция достаточно большая была территория, ну, Крым был небольшой остров, Кавказ был относительно небольшой остров, ну, есть...
Crimea was a small island, the Caucasus was a relatively small island. The film presents reconstruction that shows the paleogeography of this period of time. Approximately 15 million years, this area began to rise. 11 million years ago, the speed of the rise of the mountains increased. The uplift became even more tangible 5 million years ago. Those territories that were withdrawn from the sea and raised above it turned into the ancient Neogene land or the planation plain. Of course, it was still not the mountainous land that we see now.
Которые были выведены за пределы моря, которые стали сушей, это и как раз было древнее неогеновое суша, которое называют сейчас поверхность уравнивания. Она, конечно, это была не простая суша горная, она всего была поднята до небольшого...
The Mediterranean area was raised to a height of about 500 meters. It had numerous lakes, marshes and rivers. Volcanoes erupted in central Anatolia in Turkey. This threw out a huge amount of ash that mixed with continental sediments. So-called taffetes were formed. So all these continental deposits in aggregate formed denudation, accumulative planation plains. All stone ruts and roads are located on the Neogene planation plains. Many of the ruts are situated in tuffs and taffetes of the middle-late Miocene age, for example in Turkey, in continental sandstones, gravelites and conglomerates, for example in Termes in Spain, or as in the west of Spain, in the autonomous regions of Andalusia, Murcia, Valencia and in the Crimea, in limestones and marls, which accumulated in the shallow of shelf conditions.
В известняках, калькаренитах, так называемых, или в Крыму тоже в известняках, которые накапливаются в мелководных шельфовых условиях. Подавляющая часть этих пород находится в отложениях возраста среднего, позднего миоцена, то есть который возраст совпадает.
The vast majority of these rocks had a middle-late Miocene age from 15 to 7 million years ago. They coincide with the age of the Neogene planation plain, which includes stone ruts. That is, most of the ruts can be dated between 15 and 7 million years ago. Only in the Crimea rocks have a different age. The stone ruts in Eskikerman have the Paleocene age from 65 to 60 million years ago. In Chufut-Kale, the roots are situated in the Middle Eocene organogenic limestones from 50 to 45 million years ago.
Органогенных возрастом порядка среднего миоцена 50-45 миллионов лет. И это достаточно долго у меня вызвало размышления, долгий период размышлений, думал, поднимал геологическую литературу, как такое может быть, почему.
Such age of limestone made me think for a long time. What was the age of the stone ruts? Paleocene, Eocene or Middle-Late Miocene? Perhaps vehicles that traveled here for 30 or even 50 million years before left them. In fact, that is not so. In the Paleocene and Eocene, this territory was part of the shelf. These were shelf limestone. They were brought to the surface as a result of the mountain forming movements at the turn of the Middle and Late Miocene, 15 million years ago. At that time, limestones were in unhardened, loose plastic state as modern soil.
в рыхлом состоянии, поэтому такое нам известно, потому что когда мы бурим, ученые бурят скважины.
There is an explanation for this. When researchers drill wells in the ocean bottom, some Eocene limestones are still in an unconsolidated gate-like state. Here, perhaps it is already possible, running a little forward, to say that at the time that the planation plain, which was a land, was covered with soils, or as we now say, with loose quaternary deposits, and at that time loose middle-late Miocene sediments. No matter what, lime, mud, red sands, tuffs or taffetas.
Рыхлыми четвертичными отложениями, тогда это были, видимо, рыхлые миоценовые отложения, неважно, что известняки ли это были, красноцветные какие-то континентальные отложения, туфы или туфогенно-осадочные породы. Вот. Они представляли собой как современные почвы, какую-то глинистую рыхлую массу.
They represented like modern soil, some kind of clay, viscous mass, and apparently vehicles that left the ruts drove through them. Therefore, the traces of wheeled vehicles were so well imprinted and reach our time. Millions of years later, these ruts petrified, just as dinosaur footprints, Paleogene and Neogene animals' footprints petrified. In our time, geologists find petrified footprints, study them, and make conclusions in what rocks of what age they are situated. Thus, they determine how many years ago dinosaurs and other animals lived.
В каких породах они находятся, определяет, какого возраста были эти динозавры, эти животные, млекопитающие и так далее. То есть вот эти вот...
Thus, wheeled vehicles traveled in the middle-late Miocene through unpetrified deposits. There are many confirmations to that. First, I was lucky to see several times show the extrusion of fossil dirt on both sides of a wheel occurs. I do not know what was the tire, what material is what made of, but I saw well that a wheel squeezed the ground.
Вот колеса, которые, ну, я не знаю уж, какая была покрышка, из какого материала, но по обе стороны выходит, две стороны выдавливания грязи, как бы грязи. Она окаменела, сохранилась вот такая.
Extruded fossil mud, petrified and well preserved. Very interesting observations were made in Termes, a rock town north of Madrid. The road and ruts there are situated in red-colored continental strata. In some places, there are subsidence of ground occurred. That is, if the width of the road is usually about 2 meters, and the distance between the ruts is about 1.5 meters, then in some places it narrows to 80-90 centimeters, and then again expands. It is clear that if the distance between the wheels of the vehicle was 150 centimeters, then on the road with width 80 centimeters it could not pass in any way. That is, it is clearly traces of the floating of the soil in a plastic state when the rock had not yet petrified. There are many such places. I saw the walls of a road sagging, and later people who walked along this road dug up the stairs at the place of the ruts for convenience of movement. The landslide occurred at a later time when the road was built. Such places are found quite often. Those researchers who walk along these roads and ruts and study them have no doubt that the ruts were left at a time when the ground was in clay-viscous state.